Hey, we have another integral here today. This one's from the University of North Texas Integration B, sample problem number 7. We have the integral of x dx over 2 plus e to the x plus e to the minus x. Okay, what I found out at first is this is a little hard to deal with in the form that it's in, but a very simple move will help us out. If I multiply this integral by 1, we'll just multiply by e to the x over e to the x. I think this is going to clean it up pretty nicely. So we'll multiplying that through in the numerator, we're going to have x e to the x dx. Then in the denominator, we're going to have 2 e to the x plus e2x. And e to the x times e to the minus x, this is just going to be 1. But then you'll notice there is a nice factorization we can do for this. What I'll do is over here to the right, I won't do a formal substitution, but let's just call, just for the sake of factoring, I'm going to say, we'll say t is equal to e to the x. Then we can put this into the, we can put this denominator into the form of a polynomial. Notice e to the 2x is going to be just t squared. And then, so this term is going to be t squared. This term is going to be 2t, and then we have our plus 1. Well, that factors nicely as t plus 1 squared. That's just going to allow me to rewrite this. So we'll have our x e to the x in the numerator. But in the denominator, we'll use this, but our t, we're going to put back our e to the x. So I'm going to write this as e to the x plus 1 all squared. Okay, at this point, you may notice that this is in good shape for a u substitution. We could do a u substitution. If we call this our u, then this is going to be du. I think what I'm going to do is skip the u substitution for right now, and we're going to go to integration by parts. We'll have to use the u substitution during it, but I think let's just go to the integration by parts, and let's see how that goes. So for integration by parts, I'm going to use the DI method, or tabular integration. We'll do two columns, one to differentiate and one to integrate. And I'm just going to differentiate my x over here. And what I'm going to integrate is e to the x over e to the x plus 1 all squared. What I'll do is we'll informally use this u substitution that we did over here. So when we integrate this, we know we're really working with du over u squared, or u to the minus 2. Well, if you integrate u to the minus 2, that's just going to be minus u to the minus 1. So in short, what we're going to have over here is we're going to have 1, we'll have negative 1 over e to the x plus 1. And then for the derivative of x, this is going to give us just 1. So part of our solution is going to be right here on the diagonal. We're going to have, we can write this as minus x over e to the x plus 1. And then this here is going to be an integral, but we have minus and minus, so those are going to cancel. And we're going to have minus times minus going to give us a plus, and we're just integrating dx over e to the x plus 1. Well, what I like to do for this integral is let's just multiply, kind of the trick we did at the beginning, I'll multiply this by e to the minus x. And then let's just focus on this integral. So if we multiply that through, we'll have e to the minus x dx, and then we're going to have 1 plus e to the minus x here. We'll do a quick substitution. We'll say t is equal to 1 plus e to the minus x. Take a derivative, and our dt is going to be minus e minus x dx. Well, I can kind of create that by, if I just multiply in a minus there, I'll just do a minus up front so that we're not changing the expression. Then when we do this substitution, well, then we're just going to have our dt in the numerator, and then t here, well, that's just going to be minus ln t. What I'll do is let's just back substitute in one step here. So this is going to be minus ln 1 plus e to the minus x. And then I think before we put this back into the integral, let's just do a little fix up. So 1 plus e to the minus x, we can write as 1 plus 1 over e to the x. Well, I can get a common denominator. We can write this as e to the x over e to the x. And then we're going to have e to the x plus 1 over e to the x. Let's put that back in our natural log. But then by log properties, I can separate this out. So we can have natural log minus natural log e to the x plus 1. Although that's always positive, so I can remove the absolute value there. And then this is going to be minus ln e to the x. But I need to distribute this minus sign, so that becomes a plus. And the other thing is natural log e to the x, that actually, the e's cancel, and this just actually becomes an x. So this whole expression is going to be, we can write this as x minus natural log e to the x plus 1. Let's just go back to our problem. We need to put this back into our solution. So going back here, we just have this piece that we need to include in our solution. So let's just add that in. So for our final solution, we're going to have minus x over e to the x plus 1 plus x minus natural log e to the x plus 1. Then we'll have a plus c on the end, and that's it. We're done. So that's it. Kind of like the problems with the natural log. So we'll stop it there. Thanks, everyone, for watching today. Have a great day.